Hello friends, it's Robert with Bluebonnet. Welcome to another weekly video. This week I'm here in Whistler, British Columbia, snowboarding. And today I'm gonna take the wing out and try wing snowboarding. I went for a run yesterday, so this is my second attempt. And it was pretty fun yesterday. There's no wind, so I kinda have to make my own wing by going fast down the mountain. And then it's pretty cool to feel the pressure, and you can kinda use the wing to do turns and helps you kinda keep the pressure off the edge of the board so you can go steeper, faster turns and stuff like that. So I'm just gonna play around with it some more today and gonna shoot some video.
Okay, so first of all, I wanna say thanks to my sister Claudia, who was filming. She was on her skis filming with the phone camera, chasing me down, and so she said it was kind of crazy because, you know, like this is like an empty area, but some of the spots were, there was a lot of people, and the snow was, you know, the snow looks beautiful, but it's actually kind of hadn't snowed for a long time, so it's kind of hard pack and a little bit icy at its places, and there's a little bit of soft snow on the top surface, but underneath it's really hard, so crashing wasn't a lot of fun. And then I did try to kind of gain a lot of speed because that's when the wind developed a pressure. So the faster I went, the more interesting the wing became. And I was using a 4 meter wing, so it didn't have a ton of lift unless I was going really fast. So probably for like doing jumping and stuff like that, a bigger wing, like maybe a 6 meter or even 7 meter would be nice to try. Just to get a lot of lift when you're doing jumps and stuff like that. And because the snow was really hard, I didn't really go for any big jumps. That's kind of what I really wanted to try. But there weren't really any soft landings available, so it's kind of didn't really go for any big jumps. But I can definitely see a lot of potential. And I was kind of been looking on YouTube. I couldn't really find a lot of people using the wings in the snow. Mostly like on lakes and so on, but actually going downhill with it on a non-windy day is actually pretty fun. So it's a little bit of a gimmick, you know. It's not like you need a wing to snowboard and it's something else to take up the mountain and pump up and so on, but if you have a long run, then it's actually a pretty fun thing to do. Definitely something different, something new, and I think it has a lot of potential for tricks and kind of freestyle stuff, and you know, yeah, getting big airs. I'd love to try it like on a steep powder run or something like that. And then some areas were a little bit lower, the south facing slopes were kind of had a little bit of slush on the surface, so that was kind of a nice surface to ride on, felt a little bit like surfing. And but other spots it was like really hard and icy, and like I turned off the sound because it's not a pleasant sound. It's just like scratching on ice with the rails. So, but yeah, like trying it on powder on a powder day, and like jumping off like a sloping cliff or something like that, where it kind of just drops off. I think you could get some really good air using the wing and kind of have a softer landing than if you didn't have it. So. But also just when you generate speed and kind of do the bottom turn, the cutback, it feels real familiar, the wing handling from the water, like it's a little bit like wing foiling. Of course the wind's coming from the front, and one thing I had to make sure is that I kind of kept the wing kind of low to the side a little bit. If I got it right over my head or behind me, then it's easy to have it pull you backwards, and you obviously don't want it pulling you backwards and tipping you over backwards. But you know, otherwise it was pretty intuitive using the wing for snowboarding.
All right, I hope you enjoyed this little video about winged snowboarding. If you have a chance to try it, give it a go. It's a lot of fun, something different to try in the winter. And if you liked it, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the Bluebonnet Surf YouTube channel down below, and we'll see you on the water or on the snow. Aloha.